What is going on, everyone? It is Super here, and welcome to another Injustice 2 video. And today, we're going to be talking about a hot topic in fighting games. Whenever this topic arises, you know, it gets mixed reactions on both ends. And that is, of course, guest characters in fighting games. And today, we're going to be talking more specifically about Mortal Kombat characters in Injustice 2. Because if you guys remember, you know, obviously you guys are seeing gameplay of, you know, that specific MK character. And of course, I'm talking about Scorpion, was a guest character in the original Injustice. Quick note for you guys who might not have known, Sub-Zero was actually planned to be in Injustice alongside with Scorpion as two Mortal Kombat characters in the original Injustice. But at the time, they got so much negative feedback about Scorpion, maybe because he was insanely good when he came out and he was broken, that they actually canceled Sub-Zero being a guest character in Injustice. But of course, now that time has passed, you know, NetherRealm actually sees how many people downloaded each individual DLC character, and Scorpion was by far the most purchased, bought, downloaded DLC character. So obviously he was a huge success. So naturally, when Injustice 2 came out, a lot of people, you know, whenever Ed Boon does an interview, he gets asked all the time whether there's going to be a Mortal Kombat character in Injustice 2. And he always responds the same way, pretty much actually confirming that there will be a Mortal Kombat character. You know, he has said many times before, for example, I'll give you guys a quick example here. The way he answers specific questions, you know, they always come true. It's like a way of him saying yes, but not like outright confirming something. So, you know, for example, when Ed Boon got asked about movie tie-in skins for, you know, like Suicide Squad or Batman v Superman, stuff like that, he had mentioned it would be surprising if we wouldn't have a, for example, Wonder Woman movie tie-in skin. And then Wonder Woman comes out, and she has the exact same costume from the Wonder Woman movie that's going to be upcoming in 2017. So obviously, whenever he answers questions this way, he's pretty much like confirming things without confirming them. You know what I mean? So the same thing applies with guest DLC characters, more specifically Mortal Kombat characters. So, you know, Ed Boon got interviewed by IGN yesterday during or after the Injustice 2 panel. You know, he got asked whether there's going to be any more Mortal Kombat characters crossing over into the Injustice world. And Ed Boon responded the same way. He pretty much said, there's a novelty to having these characters, you know, like, for example, Scorpion fight Batman, something like that, you know. So there's a novelty factor in that. And also, Scorpion was by far the most downloaded character. So he said it would be surprising if they didn't have a Mortal Kombat character in Injustice 2. So, you know, I think that pretty much confirms that there will 100% be a Mortal Kombat character in Injustice. Not only that, but, you know, there's a lot of Mortal Kombat silhouettes. You know, he said that there are some hints of truth in those, you know, silhouettes, even though a lot of them are trolls. Obviously, Katana is not going to be the character. So my pick for the Mortal Kombat character that's going to be in Injustice is Sub-Zero. He is the most obvious one. I think if they combine all three variations of Sub-Zero and Mortal Kombat X, we are going to have an amazing character. Like, have his trait be the ice aura in Unbreakable, and obviously have the clone be a regular move, and have the ice hammer, you know, have a lot of that brought over from Mortal Kombat. I think that's going to be awesome. Not only that, but can you guys imagine how amazing Jim Lee is going to redesign Sub-Zero if Sub-Zero ends up being the guest character from MK coming over to Injustice 2. He made maybe the greatest Mortal Kombat character costume of all time in the Injustice Scorpion costume. Just imagine how cool he's going to make Sub-Zero look, no pun intended. But I think Sub-Zero is definitely going to be the guest character. You know, that's the absolute obvious one. They might throw a curveball here and maybe bring in another Mortal Kombat character, maybe like Liu Kang. Like, there aren't too many characters that are as iconic as Sub-Zero and Scorpion. You know, obviously Liu Kang is in there, and a couple others, but Sub-Zero and Scorpion are Mortal Kombat, so I'll be surprised if it is another character. But let me know what character you guys think will be the Mortal Kombat guest character coming over into Injustice 2. And yes, I do 100% believe that there will be a Mortal Kombat guest character in Injustice 2. You know, pretty much Ed Boon has confirmed it without confirming it. You know, he answered the same way as he answered many things that came true later on. So I can't wait to see it. I know that the first guest character, like when Jason Voorhees and Predator were in the first combat pack for Mortal Kombat, they were announced, you know, way before the game even came out. And then I believe Jason came out like 2 months after Mortal Kombat X came out. So we're definitely going to see a lot of DLC characters for Injustice 2. You know, Ed has already said they want to push the envelope with DLC characters and support the game even further. So I can't wait, man. I can't wait. Injustice 2 is going to be so fucking amazing. And I just want to hear more information. So that's going to be it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I will see you guys next time.